That tablet Riker wants has to be close. This corpse is wearing black ring garb. How strange.
Careful now. That's a trap.
The first thing you notice is the figure's empty eyeless sockets. The second thing is that your skin is crawling. The third is that your senses feel heightened. The fourth is that he is, or was, Black Ring. As your hand nears the ghost, your skin begins to itch. But more than that, your world expands, your vision narrows and fades, and your perception of the cavern is enhanced. Your nerves hum as if stretched taut. And you realize this is, or was, the ghost's reality. He was a guide, his job to know the way. You see him, on pain of purging, guide magisters into the cavern depths, there to continue their secret dig. You see him float above the traps, or vanish in one place and reappear in the next. And then, at last, you see him murdered in cold blood as the magisters left the cave. Their work here finished, his services no longer required. His wages paid with his own soul, which he was allowed to keep. You feel his anger and his confusion and his raw and naked pain, and you hear the cavern echo with his cries. He turns to you at last, those eyeless sockets staring into you, and as your senses crawl beneath your skin, you realize you know the truth already. You can do as he did. You can find your way over and around the accursed surfaces, those deadly stains that rise from the gods know what, deep underground. You have the power. You have what it takes.
Divine order. With Black Ring slaves, Lucian would be thrilled.
Be ye warned, beyond lies death. The Divine Order guarantees it. Heed the word of the White Magister. Turn ye around.
Look out. I see a trap nearby.
Like we're really not welcome here.
It might still be here. I think I made it angry.
Surely it's angry.
It's a hell of a way to express.
Thank you. Prepare yourself.
Thank you.
Prepare!
If a device breaks in a cave and nobody is around to complain, did I really break it?
Relic I found. I wonder if it has a similar effect.
The towering relic seems to hum with esoteric energy, faintly pulsating in time with the beat of your heart. You feel it drawing you closer, yearning for your touch, hungering for your source. As your palms press into the warm stone, you feel the depths of your being crack open. Your power flows from you into the relic. Yet a reverse current flows back into you with a new power, a different power. The stone warms and warms until it is suddenly too hot to touch, forcing you to remove your hands and step back.
Eternal armor could be very useful indeed. Void. It is a Shrieker! What was that? Magisters are about to become popcorn. I could help them.
Magister wipes his blooded face with a grimy rag as he strides towards you. Eyes narrowing with suspicion, he halts several feet away, one hand on the hilt of his weapon.
And you are... Voidkin, you'll not add to your collection on my watch.
The Aetirin! What an incredible discovery!
Dances in your mind. You are a sensate, deaf and mute, but gifted with an unnatural ability. Dallas seeks you out and brings you here into the darkness. When the blindfold falls, Dallas bids you find and free a secret power. You close your eyes and you feel the presence of a hidden truth. You point at it and open your eyes. You are pointing at Dallas. The hammer calmly bids you try again, then steps back into the shadows. You close your eyes once more. Now the vault before you sings to you. You raise your hand to it. It opens to your touch. From the vault, you take a sword. It's weightless, yet it feels extremely powerful. More powerful even than Dallas herself, and yet fragile. A hand falls upon your shoulder. A blade crosses your throat. Blood pours. Dallas whispers, "Good girl," and then all goes quickly dark. She raises her arm and points at you. You are powerful, and she can sense it. But then she laughs. She mocks you for what you are about to do, for the lie she thinks you tell yourself. And then it's done. The pedestal seems empty, as if it once supported something, something powerful. You surmise that this was once the resting place of the Aetirin, until it was torn free and borne away. If this is what Dallas was looking for, then she has claimed her prize.
This must be where the Magisters found the Aetirin.
Folding his arms across his chest, the Magister stares at you with baleful eyes. One by one, he points at the dead Voidwoken, the dead Magisters, the dead Silent Watchers. Then he points at you.
Your end comes, sorcerer. Just as it came for them and for me. Friedemann guided the excavation rightly. Soon, Dallas will use the Aetirin on you. And then you will be the sorcerer no longer.
He says nothing, only twists his lip bitterly as he echoes, pointing at the dead. Pointing at the dead, then pointing at you.